interesting to him. And he was telling about how he went to France and was speaking at a conference in France. And on his way from the airport to the conference, his driver asked him what he was speaking about. And he told him that he was presenting the gospel. And he said, you would have a better chance of telling them that you're going to live on the moon than you are to tell them about Jesus. But they would understand that more than they would understand the gospel. We have to be able to speak to them where they are in their life. And also, we have to be willing to have dialogue and talk with them. And not just talk with them, but to listen, to actually listen to them. Now, I'm not saying that we need to change our beliefs. That's the second thing. Truth is truth, and we have to stay with the truth. A lot of times, churches, they tend to water down the message in order to draw people in. You know, we want to make it applicable to everybody. We want to make it palatable to everybody so everyone can have the gospel. And so, in doing that, we water down what the Bible says. And we lose what it means to be a Christian and what the gospel really is. We have to be strong in the truth, but loving. It's love that makes truth palatable. People be able to eat it. But it's truth that makes love practical. So, our message has to be true, but loving. It can't be truth with no love. You see these guys on the street corners with their microphones and their big megaphones, and they shout at people that you're going to hell, turn or burn, right? It might be true that Jesus is the only way to heaven, but that's no way to reach people. You're going to shut more people off than turn people on, right? So, we have to be true. But we have to be loving in our approach and willing to have conversation and dialogue with the world around us. I got a couple of quotes here from some people, and I thought they were really, really excellent. First one is, more people object to the Christian than to the message. More people object to us than they do to our message. What is Gandhi's really famous saying? You're Christ I like. It's the Christians that I don't. So we need to live the message that we actually have, right? If we want to be relevant to the world, then we need to be relevant in our lives. Live Christianity in the community. C.S. Lewis says in his book, The Weight of Glory, he says that it is a serious thing to live in a society of possible gods and goddesses, to know that the dullest and most uninteresting person you speak to may one day be a horror and a corruption you meet now only in a nightmare, or a creature worthy of worship. Yeah, we are, in some way, helping each other to one or the other of those destinations. And Lewis is very flippant way, but he says, basically, that we, as we communicate and as we interact with people, we are helping them, either to heaven or to hell, and how we interact with them. Yesterday, I'll make a confession, yesterday, we had a little problem with our internet service, and I got a little frustrated with the guy on the phone trying to communicate with him. And I got mad, and I told him I wanted to speak to his manager, and he put me on hold for a while. But, you know, it's those little interactions we think are meaningless, but they do have significant meaning. How we communicate with people, those brief interactions, are we being real in our message? Are we really being Christ in those moments? The next one was, if the method is in violation to the message, then the people see it very clearly. If our methods violate our message, if our methods are not loving, if they're not kind, even though our message is loving, you'll never hear it. And then the last one is, conviction that is not undergirded with love makes the possessor of that conviction obnoxious. We might speak the truth, but if we don't do it in love, then we just are a gonging symbol, right? What does Paul say in 1 Corinthians 13? So, the final thought is this. We have been given the greatest of messages and the greatest of responsibilities. And that is that Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. This is the message that we are given. And this is the responsibility that God has rested on the church, the Great Commission, to take the gospel to the world. This is what He has given to us. And it's the most beautiful and most amazing message. Jesus loves you. Isn't that amazing? Isn't that amazing? God loves you. Isn't it amazing? It is, right? And Jesus loves us despite whatever we do, whatever mistakes we make, whatever problems we have, however many times we screw up, he always says, okay, let's start again. And this is the message that we have, this message of grace and hope. This is what we have. It's a beautiful thing. And we should take it to the people in a way that they can understand. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this opportunity to speak. Lord, we love you. We love you so much. We thank you for the message that you have given us, for your Bible, for your words, for sending your Son to die on the cross for our sins, for my sins. Lord, you love me so much that you did that. And you've given me the responsibility to take this message to the world. And Lord, help me to live that message. And you love me, and that you are a God of love, and that you love us so much that you sent your Son. Help me to be a Christian in the world, relevant and true and loving. Help me to be that. Help me to speak to people where they're at. I love you so much, God, and I want other people to know you. Help me to be a good Christian. Help me to be responsible for this message. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much. Nobody for you.